the major issue that I'm dealing with at this point in time is the staffing of the cyclone shelters. The problem is in Tully, it's quite a complex facility to run. I did have a band of volunteers to assist last year, but through various different things, some people have moved away, etc.
So de-amalgamation in itself has caused a lot of challenges with settling in a brand new organisation, and adding to that, having to do a new local disaster management plan. Probably getting staff trained up is a bit of an issue, and we've had issues with particularly getting people into the voluntary positions required to operate the disaster shelter.
One of our biggest problems is flooding. With the Burdekin River behind us and the Horton north of us, we tend to have a lot of flooding issues. So isolation is a big problem for us.
Bushfires is potentially a problem around some of our smaller country towns, so we've let everyone know the do's and don'ts of dealing with bushfires.
We've always had some issues with communication. We're looking at and information. We're looking at improving those.
The fact that all of our groups are surrounded by water, as in islands, we have islands surrounded by water, so we have all that problem with infrastructure, isolation and communications that we have to deal with on a daily basis in the Torres Straits.
It's human resources. It's hard enough to get your LDCC manned. The added burden of cyclone shelters is proving problematic.
It means our isolation, and because we're a shire spread over umpteen island communities, so the actual distance and the cost of actually moving equipment and people to and fro these community has always been a financial burden on our council.
We've got major urban areas as well as rural areas and coastal areas, so we have quite a few risks with cyclones, flooding and storm surge.
A lining of boundaries between disaster boundaries and local government boundaries. We've certainly taken that back to the government, and we'd like to see that that issue solved as quickly as we can.
De-amalgamation has thrown up a few issues, separating our LDMG into two separate groups now, and our resources there may have a few issues when we come to setting up a LDCC.
Kilcoy, they come under the Caboolture Police District, and we found that a problem with communications during the 2011 floods.
You deliver the message to the communities, or community, but we're wondering at times, does the actual information actually stick?
Refuge and the hardening of those facilities in the short period of time as the warning is issued for a cyclone.
Just the lack of resources. My role is just very much part-time as local disaster coordinator to my my full-time job, and I only have one other staff member to do the work, so just pure resources to get the requirements complete.
Been through had our plan reviewed, and we've sent any issues that we believe we may have a problem with. We sent them off to the DDMG, and we're awaiting those the results of their review of the plan.
So at the moment, a lot of those revolve around NDRRA. It seems that the expectations and the cost of doing response activities is ever escalating, but within the NDRRA process, a lot of significant local government activities are slowly being defined out of eligibility.